That's correct, Kevin. So far, no problems to report. And things have calmed down a little bit right now as the tide is on its way out. But earlier this morning, we did get a preview of what may be to come.
High tide Thursday morning at Hampton Beach came and went without incident, but that didn't mean there was nothing to see as the waves washed over the walls and put on quite a show.
It's thrilling to watch. You can actually feel the ground vibrating under your feet. It's very exciting.
Also enjoying the display was her 7-year-old son, David, who at times got maybe a little too close for his comfort.
What do you think of all the waves here?
They're cool. And fun.
Dylan McDonald lives nearby, and he had to come to take a look at the ocean.
It's a little sporty out here. I wouldn't want to be lobstering here, that's for sure.
Hampton Beach has several low-lying areas that are prone to flooding. There were concerns that the approaching storm combined with high tide could lead to some coastal flooding. But the fire chief says while they're not high and dry, the wet weather has not been a problem.
I drove the beach as we usually do when we're expecting this type of weather. And the usual areas that we would expect that type of flooding, we haven't seen any evidence yet.
The storm working its way up the East Coast could bring 3 inches of rain. Even that amount, the chief says, they should be able to deal with.
It's usually if we see 6+ inches of rain in a single event in a very short period of time that we get a lot of localized flooding.
But just in case, they are keeping a close eye on storm drains to make sure that doesn't happen.
In the last 15 or 20 minutes, we have noticed the winds pick up here significantly, and that brings with it the possibility of power outages here on the seacoast in addition to the coastal flooding. Reporting live from Hampton Beach, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.